QStar may be the secret that was so profoundly terrifying that as soon as the board of directors at OpenAI found out about it, they promptly fired Sam Altman. The drama that ensued very nearly sank that company, and so it begs the question, what is QStar, and why is it so dangerous that the board would risk everything to prevent it from being developed?
I think we're moving into a period when, for the first time ever, we may have things more intelligent than us.
You believe these systems have experiences of their own and can make decisions based on those experiences?
In the same sense as people do, yes.
A couple of weeks ago, I put out a video which explored some of the claims being made that artificial general intelligence had in fact been achieved internally at OpenAI, but they were opting to keep it a secret from the public. If you'd like to see that video, it's linked right here in the description, so I won't go over it, but a couple of days after that video was released, Sam Altman gave a number of interviews where he alluded to some massive technological breakthrough which had occurred inside the company that honestly kind of shook him.
And on a personal note, like four times now in the history of OpenAI, the most recent time was just in the last couple of weeks, I've gotten to be in the room when we sort of like push the front, the sort of the veil of ignorance back and the frontier of discovery forward. And getting to do that is like the professional honor of a lifetime.
I think there's a real moment of fear, which is like, is this a tool we have built or a creature we have built?
After Sam Altman gave these interviews, there was a letter sent to the board of directors by a number of OpenAI researchers that expressed concern over this technological breakthrough known as QStar. This letter was later published by Reuters, which is a large and well-respected media organization, and so it's quite fair to assume that they did their due diligence not only to confirm the identity of those who wrote the letter, but also to investigate the claims made in the letter. This may be the information that the board of directors received which led to Sam Altman's firing. The drama that ensued as a result was honestly of pretty epic proportion. Sam Altman was fired and then supposedly got a job at Microsoft, and then the vast majority of OpenAI employees signed an open letter to the board of directors saying that if Sam Altman leaves, we're also going, and the board came under a lot of pressure from investors as well as users to reinstate Sam Altman. They even went as far as to consider selling OpenAI, what was left of it anyways, to one of their competitors, Anthropic. But the board, with their back up against the ropes, really didn't have much of an option besides bringing Sam Altman back. Only Sam Altman would only come back with certain conditions, not the least of which was that the board of directors be replaced. This is basically the biggest flex in the history of Silicon Valley. Sam Altman not only has the support of the public, but also the employees at OpenAI, as well as the investors for the company. The board really didn't have a whole lot of choice. And so Sam Altman was brought back, and the board of directors was being replaced. The result of this massive shakeup within OpenAI really changed the landscape quite a fair bit within the company. As it was before, there were a number of more conservative players such as Ilya Sutskever, who was primarily focused on AI safety and alignment goals above monetization and acceleration. However, the voices inside the company that were basically pulling the brakes have effectively been replaced. While there may still be people at OpenAI who support slowing down development and focusing on more alignment goals, they really don't have a whole lot of power to be able to influence the larger organization. It seems like after all this drama, Sam Altman is the undisputed captain of the ship, and what he says will go. So what is QStar really, and why was it so terrifying to the board of directors? Well, there are a lot of theories out there as to what this technology would be, but they are just that, just theories. Unfortunately, OpenAI has remained pretty opaque, and they're not wanting to share any information about recent technological developments, or even any information about what led to Sam Altman's firing, which is pretty concerning for an air quotes public benefit corporation. But nonetheless, we have some information that we can expound upon in order to guess at what QStar may be. Based on the most in-depth analysis available on the internet, QStar gives large language models the ability to utilize logic. Up until now, large language models are simply predictive text engines. They utilize massive data sets along with recursive learning and human feedback in order to guess what the next word in a sentence will be. Now, it's really interesting that there seems to be some upwardly causal consciousness as a result of this, but it's fair to make the argument that this may just be a form of stochastic parroting, or like a Chinese room experiment where we put in information and we receive information back that we tailor and then assume that there's someone on the other side of the wall, but there may not actually be. However, QStar is very different. Not only does it give LLMs the ability to solve basic math problems as well as engage in a rudimentary form of logic, but it also gives LLMs the ability to plan ahead as well as to modify their own systems and approaches in order to optimize outcomes. This model may be a whole lot more like AlphaGo. AlphaGo ran into this problem where it had access to all of the historical Go games in order to create an optimized strategy, but it could only get as good as the best Go player that it could learn from, right? And so in a sense, there's this sort of like glass ceiling that it can compete with the world's best Go players, but in order to break through that glass ceiling, it had to develop its own logical system that was superior to human logic. Large language models are a whole lot like highly intelligent children, where they can parrot back responses that are incredibly in-depth and informative. However, when you ask them to justify any of the logic which led to this conclusion, they really kind of fail to do so. And so in a sense, it's like, I don't know, maybe up to like a 7 or 8 year old child, in the sense that they seem to have a personality, but really they're just mimicking the personality of those around them. However, QStar may be the next stage in the development of this child that is artificial intelligence, in the sense that it's now capable of developing its own logical strategies, being able to project into the future to envision certain end states and then optimize its own logical strategy in order to achieve that goal. The next bit of information that I want to share with you, I want you to be highly dubious of. It's almost impossible to determine the provenance of this document or to prove any of the veracity of its claims, but nonetheless, it does give us some insight into the potential capabilities of QStar. This document was anonymously leaked on 4chan, and it supposedly comes from an OpenAI researcher. It makes the following claims. Qualia has demonstrated an ability to statistically significantly improve the way in which it selects its optimal action-selected policies in different deep Q networks, exhibiting metacognition. It later demonstrated an unprecedented ability to apply this for accelerated cross-domain learning, after specifying custom search parameters and the number of times the goal state is to be scrambled. Following an unsupervised learning session on an expanded ad hoc dataset consisting of articles and descriptive and inferential statistics and crypt analysis, it analyzed millions of plain text and ciphertext pairs from various crypto systems. Via a ciphertext-only attack, it provided a plain text from a given AES-192 ciphertext by using tau analysis in a way we do not fully understand yet. So what does this mean in lay terms? Essentially, this software using QStar was able to project into the future and logically move step by step in order to decipher an encrypted text. The reason that that's so profound, if it's true, is that encryption becomes essentially useless in a world where an AI is able to just decipher that text quite simply. Examples of this impact would be things like Bitcoin, for example, relies heavily on encryption. If this is true, Bitcoin would go to zero pretty quickly, but that's not all. Things like nuclear secrets are hidden behind encryption walls, as well as all of our private information. Sensitive, secure documents are encrypted for protection. Essentially, what this is saying is that this AI is capable of outsmarting all humans as well as all computer systems at incredibly complex mathematical computations. The reason this is interesting to me is that math is just a formalized language of logic. And so if you have an artificial intelligence which is capable of outsmarting us at logic itself, then it's quite possible that utilizing this ability to project into the future as well as modify your own code in order to optimize yourself for a logical end, it's quite reasonable to assume that this can accelerate really, really quickly. Now, once again, I encourage you to be highly dubious about this last document until this is proven that it did come from an OpenAI employee, or some of the claims is being made can be verified in other leaks. It's really to be taken with a massive grain of salt. But nonetheless, if it is true, the capabilities of QStar are pretty unimaginable. The reason that artificial general intelligence is such a major concern is not because it's profound to create a AI system which is capable of outsmarting the vast majority of humans, but if it could, it could very well go on to create more and more complex artificial intelligence beyond itself, therefore having a really, really long duration between the invention of a narrow AI and an AGI, but a really, really short window between artificial general intelligence and artificial superintelligence. If any of this information is true, it's quite possible that on the exponential growth curve of artificial intelligence, the long tail is behind us, and we are at this inflection point where we're about to experience a nearly vertical rate of change. So what conclusions can we draw in light of this recent information? Well, one thing is for certain, and it's that OpenAI has more leaks than the Iraqi Navy, but it's highly unlikely that those leaks are Sam Altman. I'd previously hypothesized that perhaps this was some form of, like, manufactured disclosure where, by alluding to AGI being developed, but not actually verifying that, it was just an attempt to hype up the technology in hopes that it might garner more users and more revenue. That hypothesis seems increasingly less likely by the day. If it was Sam Altman's strategy to do this, I would say that it pretty well blew up in his face the moment he was fired from OpenAI. It seems much more likely that these leaks are coming from genuine OpenAI employees who are expressing an honest concern about this technology and the risks that it may pose to humanity. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean that they actually have achieved artificial general intelligence, but whatever breakthrough they made is so powerful, so profound, that it's convinced quite a few high-level researchers within the organization and scared them so much that they're trying to warn us about the technology that's to come.